Hey everybody, it's Sami-Jo, and it is Monday. I'm your Monday Fictionista, and today I am doing a book review on Kelly Armstrong's Deceptions. So this is the cover. It's all shiny and pretty and really hard to see in my office light. So Deceptions is a series. It's not a trilogy. And I guess in the beginning, somebody had released something that stated it was a trilogy. And so people were very pissed off when the book ended and they didn't have all their questions answered. But Kelly on her Facebook has stated that no, it's not a trilogy. It's actually a series. So there is more to come, which is very, very exciting because I devoured this book in two sittings. As far as the title goes in Deceptions, it's actually a little bit weird because it's high on the visions quotient. And in the first two books, the first one's name is Omens, the second is Visions, and then this is Deception. So you would think there would be more deception than there would be visions. And there is deception in it, but I mean, as far as the visions go, as it shows on the front of it is a little girl in a dress, in a sundress, and she shows up in the visions a lot. And she has a lot of messages and stuff that she thinks Olivia, the main character, needs to know. For me, I didn't always fully connect what the visions were saying and what they were trying to tell you. And eventually, obviously, you learn more about the story and pieces get put together. And that's the whole part of it. But some things I think were still left open, which might hopefully be answered in the next books. One thing was weird is that since it did start on the omens factor, I actually kind of missed the fact that there wasn't that many omens in it because that was what had been Olivia's specialty and it wasn't in it as much. There was a couple times that they actually showed birds or something that she could interpret. And then other than that, it was her saying, oh, well, I don't see any omens, or Gabriel asking if she saw omens, but she said not. So I kind of missed that a little bit, and that could just be because I really liked the other books as well. Also, in here, there was a lot of character development as far as a love triangle. And while a lot of people have opinions on love triangles, you either hate them or you love them, this one wasn't actually too bad. I found that it happened naturally with them, but it... My biggest issue was that it's connected to a destiny, which is fine, but the visions itself is how she figures all of this out. And in doing so, it kind of slows the action a little bit. So you have to try and look back and connect it to the present and future actions of the characters. And so that can be a little bit slowing to it. But I found it very interesting because there's a lot of mystery there. From where the name Deceptions could have came from, it could be in the characters themselves. There's a lot of things that happened where I think they're just kind of in denial of what's going to happen, so they're deceiving themselves. Also could be in the different fae factions or fairies that they have brought up here. I'm not going to attempt to say the names of the factions because I can't pronounce them. I have no idea what they sound like and I don't speak Welsh, so there's just no hope for it. I'm not going to embarrass myself. But it's possible that's where it comes from as well. There is also Olivia's ex who is stalking her, and there's a big mystery behind that too. And so the deceptions could be very well from there. So, I mean, it does make sense. It's just they're very vision heavy in this one, so the names were a little bit weird. For characters themselves, we have the three main ones that we follow around, which, I mean, obviously Olivia, we're in her head a lot. We're also in Ricky, which is her current boyfriend, biker, who in my mind, I pretty much think of Jax from Sons of Anarchy. He's blonde, he's a biker, he's also very smart and that sort of thing. But with him, what you see is what you get. I don't find a lot of mystery in him because there isn't much, right? But with Gabriel, he's very much the onion character here. With Olivia, we're in her head, so we know a lot of what's going on too, but not as much with Gabriel. And Kelly just managed to peel back layers and layers of him and just show us more of his character and his thoughts. And there's clearly a lot of deceiving in himself, which tends to come from a low self-worth by the sounds of it. And I don't think he is actually aware of that, but it happens and you see it there. And I really, really enjoy his character. So anytime that I could get more Gabriel, I was extremely happy. And I'm hoping that he's going to be in it even more in the next ones to come. So between the pragmatic Gabriel and the bad boy, not so bad boy, biker boy, Ricky, Olivia's got her hands full. But throughout the entire series, the whole point has been trying to figure out if her parents are actually serial killers, and if so, why. And so there's a few scenes with her parents who are in jail that she's speaking either person to person or through the glass or that sort of thing that I felt were really, really well written. I loved her father, and so you'll have to read it to see what's going on with that. But she's very much wanting to have that connection with them and trying to find out all this stuff, but what they did and why they did, it's all completely tied into her in Cainsville. I wanted more Cainsville in this book. It's not as much. She does go there, and it has a purpose in all of it, but I wanted more. And the other ones, you get to walk around Cainsville's little world and see the gargoyles and all that kind of stuff. And for me, I wanted more of that, and I didn't get that. So I'm hoping that maybe Kelly will inject more of that into the next ones, because that's the actual world, right? This is urban fantasy, so you're going to have real life and everything in it. That's the whole point of it. But I did love that fantasy aspect of that world, and what it brings and the people that are in it. Gabriel's aunt Rose, she's amazing. She pretty much knows more than anybody. She sees things that are going to happen and that sort of thing. And you get the sense that she wants to smack them upside the head and get them all to pay attention to what's in front of them. And so it's a wonder why they don't utilize her more often. But characters like her and the elders and Patrick and stuff like that were really fun characters to have around in the other ones, and they were in this one, but like I said, I feel like I wanted a little bit more of them. So anybody who hasn't read the series, I highly recommend that you get a hold of it. Like I said, the world that Kelly has created in Cainsville is super interesting, and it has a lot of factors in there. Anybody who enjoys the urban fantasy genre will absolutely love. And then characters like Olivia and the sort of bad boy, not bad boy, Ricky, and Gabriel, who I will fight to the death, is my absolute favorite. He is amazing. So get a hold of it and peel back the onion layers of Gabriel, if you will, and have fun with that. And I mean, pick up anything from her, because I'd recommend it to death. So yeah, that's it for me for this time. I will be diligently waiting for the next time that I get to pick up a Kelly Armstrong Cainsville book. And I will see you next week. Make sure that you're sharing and tweeting and all that fun stuff and listening to the Fictionistas all week. Thanks, guys. Bye.